Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will explain how blackbox testing identifies security gaps and prevents potential vulnerabilities for startup and enterprise-level organizations. So let's get started. Blackbox security testing is a software testing method used to examine the functionality of an application with limited knowledge of its architecture or internal processes. This approach, also known as closed-box testing, relies on outputs from implementing specific execution conditions on selected inputs to observe the application's functionality. For example, a blackbox penetration test helps organizations reduce their attack surface by uncovering the development team's common vulnerabilities during code testing undetected. QA teams can also build test cases for specific usage scenarios, which provide application performance information from a user's point of view. When to implement blackbox scanning? Blackbox testing examines various aspects of an application's functionality. As a result, blackbox testing techniques are applicable across multiple phases of the SDLC, including integration testing for new features during deployments and rollouts. In production, to understand application usability and the user experience. During acceptance testing, to understand the effects of third-party solutions on application security. During quality assurance, to ensure the application works as expected before deployment. A blackbox penetration test can be categorized primarily into three types of testing. These are functional testing. A form of closed box testing examines how the software performs against specific functional requirements. The tests check the software's mainline functions, user interface, databases, security, etc., by supplying a particular input and comparing its output with the expected behavior. An ethical hacker develops functional test cases based on business scenarios and other applicable requirements to determine the application's conformance to SLAs in such a testing approach. These cases can either be automated or achieved by manual penetration testing, and they typically focus on the system's accessibility and error conditions. Non-functional testing. Non-functional testing examines the non-functional requirements of the application, including performance, reliability, and usability, among others. These parameters are commonly used to measure the application's ability to run effectively within its deployment environment. Therefore, a non-functional test provides detailed information on the application and tech stack's behavior, helping avoid runtime security vulnerabilities. Aspects covered by this type of testing include software performance testing, load testing, stress testing, volume testing, compliance testing, portability testing, configuration testing, recovery testing, regression testing. Regression testing is a blackbox security testing method used to validate whether a recent update has affected the application's existing functionality. The approach involves a partial dynamic analysis test that re-executes test cases on existing features to ensure new changes do not incur unwanted side effects. Regression tests are mainly used when a new version of source code has been deployed or when segments of code fixes have been released. Acting as a foundation for the acceptance testing approach, regression testing can be automated using tools that build test libraries out of varying combinations of previous test cases, thereby reducing the manual efforts of QA teams. Testers use several blackbox pentest techniques to design test cases for varying requirement specifications. These blackbox testing types include equivalence partitioning. A blackbox security testing method derives test cases from data classes within the input domain. A typical test case divides the input domain into equivalent classes partitions and then evaluates each class for specified input conditions. The software requirements and specifications additionally define the equivalence partitions. Test cases also validate whether the values of a partition behave the same as other equal partitions, thus determining valid or invalid inputs. Boundary value analysis, BVA. This blackbox pentesting technique uses boundary values, values at the lower and upper limits of variables, to identify the source of input errors. Using this technique, testers design test cases to examine application functionality at the beginning and end of each partition using test data. Boundary value analysis is commonly used to identify system errors at the extreme ends of the input domain and only applies to test cases where the partitions are ordered sequentially or numerically. State transition testing. A blackbox penetration testing technique is used to observe how the application behaves under a sequence of different input conditions. Testers provide both negative and positive input values to the application server to record the valid and invalid state transitions. These tests are most appropriate when determining an operation's dependencies on past values. This technique also tests real-time systems with multiple states, transition events, and associated conditions. Decision table testing. A systematic closed-box testing approach that tabulates input combinations and their respective system behavior to help evaluate the combinations of input data the application can handle. The decision table correlates inputs versus the rules, test cases, or conditions to map cause and effect relationships to form the foundation of structural testing. Error guessing. With an error guessing mechanism, black box penetration testers rely on their expertise to infer sources of issues within the application. This level of software testing is unstructured, since it does not follow any specific rules conventions. A testing team develops test cases using experience with similar performance requirements and software vulnerabilities with this approach. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.